Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel. Not the nicest video to make, but it's about this guy. I don't think he's very well. If you're new to the channel, this is my Flowerhorn Humphrey. He's down here at the moment. I don't know what's going on, so this is mostly a video to ask for help. I know that's probably the silliest thing you can do in the universe, is ask the internet to help diagnose something, but I'm kind of at a loss and I don't know where to go with this. It's possibly my favourite ever fish, individual fish anyway. I want to do everything I can to help him, but nothing I'm doing is working. If you've been joining me on my live stream for the last couple of weeks, you might have heard me talk about Humphrey. He's called Humphrey. He's not been very well. I've tried a few things, so I thought I'll make a video where I take you through the history, what I've tried, what I'm doing, and I'm basically just throwing it out there, the last gasp attempt to find something that I can do that'll help. So a few weeks back, I had a bit of a filter faux pas where the filter got pinched and the return got stopped to the point where it went through a little bit of a crash. I saw a very small amount of ammonia in the water. Lots of water changes, got that fixed, and Humphrey, when he's upset by something, his nuchal hump, his cock, deflates. That happened. So it's happened before, but he's not been happy about something, usually when I move tanks or something like that. And I thought, it'll get better, and a couple of days later, we'll all be good. And it was, to be fair, it lasted a couple of days, and it got better. And then it went again. And then his personality is always very aggressive. You might have seen him in previous videos where he's always charging around the tank, trying to bite me, trying to kill anything. A very aggressive feeder. He knows when he's getting fed, but he's just been so lethargic. He would hang out at the bottom of the tank and at the top of the tank. I noticed some things, almost like bacterial nodes or little bumps on his nuchal hump, which I thought, oh, here we go, hole in the head. Might be hex, might be something like that. I treated him with hexameter, with some Escher hexameter. Went through that course and it seemed to come round. Almost as soon as I noticed the little marks on his head, they went away and they never came back, so I might have misdiagnosed that. But we went through the treatment and certainly his nuchal hump came back, but he remained very lethargic, very pale in colour. So we went through that for a while. Again, I'm doing water changes every other day, large water changes, trying to get the water parameters back to perfect, and they have been for weeks now. Then I noticed him both hanging out at the bottom of the tank and at the top of the tank, more at the top of the tank, so I added air, which you might see here. Get some extra oxygenation into the tank. It didn't really make a difference. And then he has been going very dark and very pale, changing by the hour, it seems. Again, hanging out at the top of the tank still. Today, he started hanging out at the bottom of the tank here and is being a little more interactive. He usually follows my fingers quite readily, but he's starting to come back to it, but he's not the right colour. He's not quite back to normal. I have noticed him listing every now and again, rights himself almost immediately, but it's just not right and I don't know what to do. And then today I've noticed what almost looks like pine coning on some of his scales. So I'm thinking dropsy now. So I've raised the temperature. The temperature is on its way to being 30 degrees Celsius. We're at 29.2 at the moment, so it's going up. Dropsy is something I've not had a lot of experience with, but the experiences I have had have been very bad because I've not managed to save a fish that's caught dropsy. I don't know that that's what it is, but I'm kind of running out of ideas. The other thing that I've treated for in the last couple of weeks is worms, because he's not been eating. He's hardly eaten anything. He has occasionally taken some pellets. His normal diet is a mixture of fluval bug bite pellets and Hikari cichlid gold, mixed in with some frozen foods and things like that every now and again. You might see there's some pellets in there at the moment, he's just ignored them. So he hasn't eaten properly. He's usually a very ready, aggressive feeder, and he just hasn't been. And yeah, I'm getting a bit stumped. In terms of water quality, the water quality's been fine. We had that little blip a few weeks ago, and it's been fine ever since. All the parameters are at zero. The same water as all the other tanks, so on the live stream we discussed this, whether the water company had made any changes, but none of the other fish in the fish room have been affected. Every other fish is fine. All my water comes in, runs through HMA filter, which is like a carbon block filter. So I haven't noticed anything in any of the other tanks. It's just Humphrey's tank. So conscious of the fact that I've used the hexameter, I've done a warming treatment, I'm raising the temperature. What I don't want to do is start throwing in all kinds of meds, because medicating fish often has just as bad an effect as not medicating a fish, because it can be stressful on the fish. So I'm looking for advice as to be more specific as to what's going wrong and make sure I treat the right thing, because I'm not sure me just going through every kind of medication that I can find is going to be in any way helpful, because that might just finish him off. I've been trying them with food every day, quite often a couple hours later I'm having to vacuum it out and get it out of there before it starts to rot and deteriorate. If I try him every day, maybe every third day, he'll take one pellet, whereas normally he would take a whole handful of pellets every time. I've had Humphrey for about 4 years, so I got him quite young, so he might be 4.5 years old, something like that. Lifespan I would expect to get longer out of that. Pre-existing conditions, nothing really. He's had a gill curl since day one, since I got him, but it's never affected him in the past. He's always been fairly healthy. Like I say, the only time he gets a little bit moody is if I move him tanks, and he usually bounces straight back really quickly. I don't know what to do. So at the moment I'm letting the air continue to run. I am raising the temperature. This is an improvement, the fact that he's coming to the front of the glass and almost interacting a little bit. So I'm hopeful that I've turned a corner, but help me out. What else can I be doing? What should I be doing? What can I be thinking of? I'm not an expert in any of this. I just have a lot of fish tanks and a lot of fish. I'm by no means an expert in diagnosing fish diseases, and I don't have a ton of experience dealing with fish diseases. So I'm relying on you. I realise that asking for help on the internet, I'm going to get 100 different answers with 100 different suggestions, but I promise you I will read them all. I don't mean any offence if I can't try everything that you suggest, but I'm looking for things that I might not have thought of, and I am an idiot. It's quite possible I have not thought of it. So if you can think of anything at all, anything to look for, to try and diagnose, similar experiences you might have had with either big cichlids or other fish at all. How can I confirm a diagnosis against another? Join my Discord server if you want me to share more detailed pictures and things like that. I might be able to do that. But yeah, just looking for help. I will read all the comments. I won't be able to try everything, but I really appreciate any help that any of you can give. Just a quick video today with that. Thank you very much for sparing some time, and hopefully a more positive update to come soon. Bye-bye.